you wrote this book really quickly, but there it feels like there's a lot of research in there. And there is a lot of research. One character, Captain Truss, who's a great character, he's based on George Cartwright and Cartwright's diaries. So did you just know a lot about this stuff? Had you read a lot of this stuff so that you didn't actually have to reference it and draw it in bit by bit as you might have if you'd hadn't known it?
Well, I mean, yes, to a certain extent, that's true. Like, my first novel, River Thieves, is set around the same time this. So for that book, I had done months of research.
Oh, okay.
And when I started River Thieves, I knew nothing about the time that I was writing about. And that was one of the most frustrating writing experiences I've ever had, you know, because I'd be writing along, and I'd have two people in a room, and I would think, well, what are they wearing? I have no idea what people wore at the time. Or what would they be eating? I have no idea. And I couldn't just leave the blanks. So I was constantly researching as I went and still getting stuff completely wrong. After I had finished the book and it was already accepted for publication, I'd written the whole book with people like making tea on their stoves and putting wood in their stoves. And I found out nobody back then had stoves. They all... fireplaces. So it was like working on an old house. You know, I had to go through and haul out all the stoves and then shove in the fireplaces. But a lot of the work that allowed me to have a sense of what their lives might have been like here had already been done.
Right.
But there were three books that I read before I started, before I sat down and started writing. One was Cartwright's.
Right.
And that was a book that my intention was to go back to the archives and to talk to people and stuff like that. But I took Cartwright's book off my shelf, which had been there for a long time I hadn't read. And it was because it was from around that time, around 1790 or so. Full of amazing detail, which is what I was after. But he was such a character that I thought, you know, at some point I've got these two children alone in a cove and I can't just leave the book like that. Like, there, something has to happen. And I thought, well, I could just have Cartwright under a different name show up in the cove. So he was one. And then there was The Life and Times, or The Life and Travels of John Nicol, Mariner, who is Scottish seaman from around the same time, sailed all over the world on Navy ships, whalers, traders, and spent some time in Newfoundland. So I thought, okay, I'll have him arrive as well. So there was all kinds of details from those books that ended up in this novel. And to sort of justify my laziness of not looking at anything else after I'd read those books, I thought, okay, the book is about two youngsters stranded in this tiny cove, and they know nothing outside the cove except what washes up on the shore, right? These people that arrive, or this wreck of a ship that's caught in the ice. So I thought, well, I will write this book in the same way, and my office will be the cove. And whatever I can find in this office is what goes into the book.
Right.
And I'm more or less stuck to that. I cheated a little bit with the internet, with the Google. But I thought, it's in the office. So... it's sort of the same.
Everybody cheats with Google.
Yeah. So I mean, that's where I found the Dictionary of the Vulgar Tongue, right? That was online.
Okay.
That was an online thing.